Yo guys, how y'all doing? It is me, Tommy Rony. 1, 2, 3, guys, back with a squad builder, just for you lot. Just for you lot, the viewer squad builder. Yes, it's a bit of a different setup, guys, bear with me. Just, you know, enjoy the squad builders nonetheless. Obviously, comment down below what your console is, what your budget is, what players you have untradeable, and what you're looking for, guys. And I'll sort that out for you, put you on the list, get the video out, and get you out there, guys. Obviously, a shout out for everyone. But make sure you like and subscribe, because that's what helps this channel to grow, and helps me to grow, obviously, as a person on this, you know, platform. I'm making a very long. I don't need to make it that long for you guys. Let's get straight into the squad builders. First squad builder, guys, of this whole thing, and it's a 400k. If I want to choose Leon Berg and Kunku, the passing one, and obviously De Ligt, road to the knockouts. And guys, as I said before, I don't do ifs, buts, or maybes. I do absolutes, and that's exactly why I am here giving you guys all three of them. Let's get straight into it. We're gonna put Wojciech Szczęsny in goal, the Polish maestro from Juventus, who keeps making mistakes in real life because he thinks he's so cool. But we move past that, guys. That's just my Polish agenda against him. Juan Cuadrado is going to play our right back for us. As I forget to make Ljungberg, I forgot to make Ljungberg untradeable. There we go. Yeah, Cuadrado is going to be right back, guys. Cuadrado's 5-star skills, 3-star weak foot, an absolute monster in the game. He does attack a lot, but if you tell him to stay back, he'll still stay back for you. And obviously, his pace. He's got his pace. He's definitely not going to let you down, guys. Now, we're going to be going down the left side with Joe Gomez to begin with, guys. Yes, he might not be how he was in last year. He might not be the same, but guys, he's still an absolute beast. He's got the pace, and he's got the defending and physical stats as well. You just need to give him Anchor. Give him Anchor, and he'll do the job for you. Joe Gomez definitely is still one of the best cards in the game. Next, we're going to have Robertson at left back. Yes, Premier League is kind of very, very slacking in terms of the left back department, and so we're kind of letting down all these squad builds I'm trying to do, because I'm constantly thinking of what left back to use for Prem, but we're stuck with what we're stuck with, and we really have to just live with it, and you know, at the end of the day, do our job, which is win the games, guys. Next up, we're going to have Bernardo Silva, right to the knockouts. He's going to fit in perfectly there because he gets that green link to Ljungberg, of course, just because he's allowing us to kind of build that team, you know, in terms of a bit more attacking impetus, you know, because obviously Nkunku and Goretzka, who's going to be the next player, they're going to be playing that kind of defensive role for us. They're going to play that CDM role for us, and even though they are still attacking based players, they are nonetheless going to cause a lot of problem for the opposition in terms of the midfield area. You need someone up there to create the chances, and that's Bernardo Silva for you. That's Bernardo Silva's job. Gnabry is going to be up there with Goretzka and Nkunku, helping them out in the transition, trying to weave the passes in and out, weave the passes, guys. That's what his job is going to be in this team. And then lastly up front, guys, we are going to put on Mario Gomez, the legend himself. Mario Gomez, back in the day, was the one, wasn't he? He was an absolute beast. And obviously, he links to Ljungberg as well as he links to Gnabry, and finishes off this 400k squad builder for us. On to the next one. Okay, this next one's a bit of a mad one, but someone wants a 600k team because they just packed Kylian Mbappe. Well, lucky you, my friend. You have come to the right place. Let's start off with Lloris in goal. We're going to be doing a bit of a French builder here, I should call it. It's going to be a French squad builder. Lloris begins in goal on right back position. Yes, we're moving away from France for a second. It's going to be Jesus Navas in form, an absolute beast. He might be small, he might be 5'6", 5'7", if I'm correct. It doesn't matter, he does the job. And in every single game, what you'll see from Jesus Navas is complete and utter passion for the game. Passion champs is literally what he plays. He doesn't play foot champs. Koundé is going to be our next player. Jules Koundé is going to play at the other centre back role, the right center back role, linking himself to Jesus Navas. Meanwhile, on the left one, we're gonna have Varane. Once again, that link that I like to do between a tall and a small defender, both of them with pace, but a small defender offers something extra, you know, that extra agility and balance, allowing us to have that kind of extra you know, quick turns, being able to adapt to quick movements, and being able to deal with the problems that come our way. Next, I'm going to be placing Theo Hernandez into the left-back position, my favourite left-back in this whole game. I think he's better than Ferland Mendy. He just has a bit more strength, a bit more aggression, and just makes him a bit more deadly. That's why I prefer Theo Hernandez myself, guys. Ousmane Dembele is going to be the next player. His rule breaker was obviously making a feature on our last squad build, I think, this morning, so make sure to check that out. But here we're going to be using normal Ousmane Dembele. He's five-star, five-star is the cheap Neymar. Pogba, the one and only Pogba, who's Mr. Inconsistent in real life, but Mr. Consistent for France. That's why we put him around the whole French team, so Pogba can perform for us. Next time we're going to be off Tanguy and Ndombele. Tanguy and Ndombele is someone you give shadow to, and I think he becomes better than Kante in the game. His dribbling just makes him an absolute monster. 90 dribbling for a player like him, of his kind of build. Unreal, guys. I don't know how he does it. Moussa Diaby makes it into the team as well. He's rule breaker, one of the most enjoyable cards I have used this year, and he's finally confident in front of goal. You know, you don't have that trouble with him, which usually would with Diaby every year, which is just going up front and having a chance. And lastly, Karim Benzema makes it up top. He's in form next to Mbappe, because at the end of the day, you know, Benzema is going to always be that kind of player causing trouble for the opposition with his ability to shoot and with his ability to create. And that's why Benzema has to be in the team. On to the next one. Next, we are here with another popular and very common request, and that is Fekir untradeable in a team. Let's get straight into it. We're going to start off with Neuer. We're going to build a Bundesliga backline here because we want that extra pace and we want that extra physicality. And I feel like Bundesliga players are very physical this year, with someone like Mukiele, with someone like the new Klostermann. Now, the new Klostermann, I have to tell you guys, we'll look at the card, give him anchor, and just watch and weep what he will do to the opponents. Unbelievable. Next time we're going to have Upamecano in form, because we want that link to Fekir. We want Fekir to feel nice and secure in that position and know that he will be protected, guys. So Upamecano is going to be the next player. Next to them, we are going to be putting, not Theo Hernandez this time, actually. I misplaced that, guys. It's going to be Amavi, the next player that was on the list. I like Amavi. I feel like a lot of people are sleeping on him, but his dribbling is very, very good. It just makes him a left back that many people do not fear. But when he performs, he performs. He's like Evra used to be back in the day. And Amavi is a perfect culmination of those kind of abilities that you need at left back. Definitely a player to get. Next, we're going to put in Goretzka. As always, Kulik gang, Mr. I like going gym with Lewandowski and his wife. If you follow his Instagram, you know what I'm talking about. Goretzka is an absolute monster. And there's no way that Goretzka doesn't make it into our team when it comes to Bundesliga side. As the same case goes for someone like Serge Gnabry, one of the best right wingers I have played with. I know he might be a bit more bulky and might be a bit more fat for some reason. EA just decides he's not that fast. I've seen him play in real life. He's fast. He's goddamn fast. But it is what it is. He still performs. He still gets his shots off and he still scores the goals. Next, we're going to have Hiro Riken. Now, someone that many people are not using. I think he's usable if he's used in the right way. And you need to kind of just place him in that role where he's kind of like a false nine. You know, plays a bit deep as a center forward, as a cam. Picks up the ball and plays it off. Rickens one of the best at doing that. So he definitely has to fit in. Next, we're going to be putting Erling Haaland. Haaland, Haaland. I don't know the rest of the lyrics of that song because I don't speak Norwegian. But Erling Haaland. It's only 20k, and I'll never understand this. I know people think he's bulky, he's clunky or whatever. I think he's just nonsense. Look at the goals he scored from you in my rank 1 highlights. Time and time again, Haaland proved to be the player to kind of use for me, and I've never been let down by him. So I'm going to put him straight into the team because I trust him. And next time I'm going to put another player I trust a lot, Moussa Diaby. By far one of my most favorite players that EA has brought out during Rule Breakers. Goals after goals after goals. It's goals galore with someone like Moussa Diaby. And it will never stop. He is a constant ongoing goal merchant. Guys, this is your 700k team with Fekir untradeable. On to the next one. Yes, guys, change of shirt because guess what? That's just how I do things, guys. Straight into another one. 700k. We have Fekir and Kante untradeable. Kind of like I said, it's a pattern now. Everyone's got Kante and Fekir untradeable. And we're going to once again go with a PSG link-up at the back. Because this PSG link-up for me is the best in the game, guys. I'm not going to be capping here. I'm not going to lie to you. Marquinhos, Hakimi, Donnarumma. These are my favorite players in the whole wide, you know, the whole game when it comes to the back line, guys. It doesn't get better than that. And how about you back it up with Rafael Varane as well, just to compliment Marquinhos there. He's unbelievable. And we're going to put in a new left back here, guys. And I like that finally we have a new left back. And it's going to be Cornet, a rule breaker from Burnley. Look at this guy's stats for left back. Absolute beast, Cornet, man. And I know he scores goals for Burnley, and that dynamic image is when he scored those goals for Burnley. But wow. Wow, wow, wow. And he's been a, you know, breath of fresh air over there at to have more. Here we have, guys, not that Usman Dembele for 700k. Of course not that one, guys. We're going to be going for normal Usman Dembele on the right side for that five star linkage. We're going to put in Tchouaméni to link into our players, the little Liga on link and the French link. Obviously, as I said before, Tchouaméni is one of the best box to box centre mids in the whole wide game. On the left-hand side, guys, we're going to have Heung-min Son. And Heung-min Son is definitely going to be a player that's going to be one of our, you know, kind of standout players here. What you have to remember with Son as well, guys, is he's going to be on 7 chem. That's okay. Don't stress it. It's not the end of the world. And lastly, guys, it's a 700k team. We're going to have to put in Benzema in form just for the little linkage to the French players as well. Benzema is obviously one of the best strikers in the world and one of the best strikers in the game as well, guys. He is one of the best. And obviously, once you get all the links, guys, in terms of manager and loyalty, you'll see that obviously this team will be 100 chemistry. So don't worry about that. On to the next one. And the last one, guys. 1.5 million team with Red Pick Mane and Road to the Knockouts Bernardo Silva untradeable. It's that link between those two again, which is going to be absolutely OP here, guys. We're going to start off in goal with Alisson, one of the best goalkeepers in the Premier League and one of the best goalkeepers in the whole game. He's an absolute beast, guys. And we're going to have Trent Alexander-Arnold Rule Breaker, our right back. Now, Trent Alexander-Arnold is not usually one of the best cards in the game, but he's Rule Breaker. Insane, guys. The pace upgrade has made him unstoppable, and he can dribble better than ever, and he can pass, guys. What, it's an all-round card. It's an absolutely beast card, guys. Van Dijk is going to slot right in with Varane, obviously the best Premier League duo you can have, a center back with both the pace and agility and all the defending stats and the physicals. There's no one better. It's an impenetrable defense that's only going to get backed up at left back, guys, with Cornet. One of the best left backs, like I said before in the previous team that we were building, Cornet is an absolute monster. Obviously, with Bernardo Silva and Mane, we're going to need someone in CDM and not Kante, guys. Onyeka. Onyeka is going to fulfill it because I want someone physical with these smaller players in and around. You know, especially in this team where you're going to probably play 4-1-2-1-2, you need players that are going to be boosting up your physicality. And players like Onyeka are perfect for that. Next, right winger, guys, will be going Mohamed Salah, aka the Egyptian King. One of the best cards in the game, guys. His left foot is a rocket, man. It's an absolute rocket of a shot. One of the most enjoyable cards that I have used this year, for sure. And I'm sure that you guys will not be regretting getting it either. Now, left wing, guys, we're going to be going with a hero card. We're going to go with Ljungberg, because Ljungberg is one of the best cards I have actually used in terms of dribbling. He just feels like a monster, guys. His shooting might be his biggest flaw, but you give him a chemistry style and he'll do the job for you. And lastly, guys, up front, we're going to be putting Robbie Keane himself. He's monstrous, absolutely monstrous, guys. And as you can see, we have some coins left over, and when you have coins like this left over, guys, you can even go for Salah inform if you want to. So let's put Salah inform. Bang, Salah inform. Look at this team. It's just colors FC. Beautiful team, guys. I hope you enjoyed all the squad builders. Make sure to comment down below with your console, how many untradeables, what your budget is, and I'll do the team for you, guys. And until next time, I hope you have an incredible day, and peace.